This is the new Raspberry Pi 5. And it's kind of amazing. It's got a new CPU, GPU, custom Raspberry Pi silicon, the RP1. Who are these guys? Apple? And everything is like twice as fast on the Pi 5. USB transfer speeds, micro SD card transfer speeds. It has a PCIe 2.0 interface. The RAM is faster, HDMI is better. It has better camera connections. This thing is so powerful, they had to make an active cooler for it. Have they ever done that before? I don't know. It's got everything. We have a power button. Frankly, that's all I needed to know. I'll take 20. But seriously, the Raspberry Pi 5 is kind of amazing. Like, can it truly be a desktop replacement? Can we game on this? Can we hack on this thing? We will do a deep dive on the specs, do a few benchmarks, and see how it performs against the Raspberry Pi 4. I'm really excited to play with this. Are you ready? Let's do this. Now, the release of the Raspberry Pi 5 right now is a pretty big deal. We haven't had one for 4 years. 2019 is when the Raspberry Pi 4 came out. And also, Eben Upton said we wouldn't have a Raspberry Pi in 2023, but we are going to! In fact, let me drop that for you real quick. So, you'll be able to buy a Raspberry Pi 5 fresh off the line, I think, in October, sometime in October. And you'll have two options to choose from, starting with the 4 gig model at $60 US and the 8 gig model at $80 US. That's right, no more 2 gig model, just two options. Now let's take a deep dive into the specs. What's making this thing tick? Why is it so great? And it is. First, the CPU. We've got a whopping 2.4 gigahertz, quad core 64-bit ARM Cortex A76 CPU. This thing is intense. They say it's got 2 to 3 times the performance over the Raspberry Pi 4. We're gonna test that here in a bit. It also has cryptographic extensions to help with, you know, cryptographic things like security, VPN, encryption. Now the GPU is also pretty crazy. We have an 800 megahertz video core V2 GPU supporting OpenGL ES3.1 and Vulkan 1.2. And we'll need that GPU for the dual 4K 60p HDMI output with HDR support. I told you, it's like a full-on desktop PC. Now I think the biggest thing is the RP1. This is silicon designed in-house by Raspberry Pi. The RP1 is their Southbridge, the chip that controls the I/O between the CPU and external peripherals. So think USB ports, Ethernet ports, storage interfaces. Now what this unlocks is faster everything. USB speeds. Now similar to the Raspberry Pi 4, we've got two USB 2.0 interfaces and two USB 3.0 interfaces, but the USB 3.0 can do 5 gigabits per second. Simultaneous 5 gigabit per second operation. Now that's crazy. That's a big deal for, I don't know, making a Raspberry Pi NAS, which we did. The 5 will blow that one out of the water. This also enables a big change in camera interfaces. On previous models, we had a dedicated 1 gigabit per second, 2-lane MIPI camera and display interface. That's been replaced by a pair of 4-lane 1.5 gigabits per second MIPI transceivers. This triples the total bandwidth, supporting a combination of up to 2 cameras or displays. And I know some of you are looking for onboard storage. Like, that was something I was kind of hoping for. But they gave us higher SD card speeds. They say that peak SD card performance is doubled. They're supporting now the SDR104 high speed mode. And then this one is just kind of crazy, but they now have a PCIe 2.0 interface. This opens up a whole new world for high bandwidth peripherals. I mean, just, oh my gosh. The projects this opens up for us, are you kidding me? So think like maybe network cards, connecting SSDs, just faster, better, everything. Now the RAM also got a facelift. We're now rocking LPDDR4X-4267. And then of course, we can't forget the thing that was on everyone's wish list, the power button. It's here, it's finally here, and it's a button. You press it and it does stuff. We're gonna find out what exactly it does here in a bit. Now, Wi-Fi is still the same. Dual band 802.11ac. We still have Bluetooth 5, but we also have BLE, or Bluetooth Low Energy Support. It also has an RTC, or real-time clock, powered by an external battery. So when your Raspberry Pi turns off, it's still keeping time. Okay. The first thing I'm gonna do is set up a Raspberry Pi desktop. Now here I've got a 4K monitor and another 4K monitor. Now the reason I'm doing this, because the Raspberry Pi 5 can now support dual 4K 60 frames per second outputs. 4K dual 60 frames per second. Let's test it out. As I mentioned earlier, the Raspberry Pi comes with an active cooler. I believe this is the first time they've ever made one because this sucker draws so much power and produces a ton of heat because it's doing more things, it's faster.
Okay, this thing is just cool. So it looks like it has adhesives already on there for the components that need to be chilled off, like the RP1, the GPU, and the CPU. And I'm hope I'm doing this right. Oh, it's got a little thing, a little screw. I guess if I line those screws up, I'm also kind of golden. It's in place. I think. Punch it through. Punched in one, punched in two. Okay, cool. So it kind of had a punch in spring lock action, which was kind of nice. Now it's in there. I don't think it's ever coming out. So you're in there for good, buddy. But that's a snug little, dare I say, sexy cooler. Now the last thing to do is plug in the fan connector to the fan header on the Raspberry Pi, which I believe that is it, right? Boom, active cooling solution installed. That's actually kind of awesome. It's kind of, dare I say, cool. Sorry. All right, I've got to go to my stand-up meeting with my team. I'm gonna take this guy, let him join the meeting.
Good morning. So I brought someone special to the meeting today. It's the Raspberry Pi 5.
Are you for real right now? Oh my god.
My team loved it. Good job, Raspberry Pi. So now with our active cooling installed, let's plug it up and see what happens. Now what I'm really curious about is if I power the sucker on, will it just come on like it used to? Or will it wait for me to press that power button? Okay, both HDMI cables plugged in should give us
4K 60 FPS.
Definitely help if I had this power cable. Almost forgot that. Moment of truth, let's see if the power cable turns it on. Okay, we got a red light. Oh, there goes the active cooler, and will we get display? Oh my gosh, I can feel the air coming out of it. That sucker's powerful. Oh, and there it goes. It's actually not that quiet. Almost forgot to get my keyboard out. There we go. Fresh Raspberry Pi keyboard. And of course, we also need the mouse. Mouse does indeed work. I've got all my Raspberry Pi peripherals plugged in. All right, it's super tiny, but now it's telling us we have some things to do to get started. Let's go. So far, this seems like a pretty typical Raspbian setup. Sorry, Raspberry Pi OS. I can never get used to saying that. I was actually curious. It did come with an SD card already installed, and I was hoping they'd have Raspberry Pi OS for me already, and they did. Thank you. Now, searching for a Wi-Fi network, it's having trouble. Okay, definitely should have found one by now. I'm just gonna click on next. We'll skip the software update. There's no Wi-Fi. And now let's restart. Listen to that thing. Ooh, look at that. Okay, this actually looks kind of amazing. They got a nice background here. No Wi-Fi just yet. Let me see if I can get a connection now. It seems to legit be having trouble connecting to Wi-Fi. Oh, I was missing an O. We're connected. I was getting worried about that. Now I'll go ahead and just do my system update. Got a bunch of stuff to do. Let's go ahead and install everything and take a little coffee break. Now what I want to do is see if the Raspberry Pi 5 could kind of be a desktop replacement. How does it feel to use it? And we'll do all kinds of crazy stuff. Now first, one thing I noticed, and I tested this out, is that when I press the Pi 5's power button, while the system's up, pressing it will prompt you to go, do you want to shut down, restart? You press it again, it just shuts down. Let's try booting it up by pressing the button. Yep, there it goes. I'm a huge fan of the power button. I hate having to unplug it, plug it back in. I feel like I'm breaking it every time. This is fantastic. So what do you say we do a few things like, I don't know, let's watch some videos. Okay, so I'll launch a web browser here. Now notice it's not like the snappiest thing in the world. We're on an SBC, a single board computer, but it is on two 4K 60 frames per second monitors. So I mean, as I'm moving back and forth, it's a little laggy. Let's get a video going. Looks like our fan has already engaged, cooling our system. Okay, so we got one video here. It looks pretty good. Now this is 720p playing. If I expand this, you'll be able to tell that pretty well, but this is kind of testing the networking. Notice it is taking a bit to expand it. Kind of testing the networking video. As we can see here, GPU usage is at 98%. CPU is pretty good, but yeah, GPU is kind of like stressing out a little bit. Check our temp, 51 degrees. We're climbing, and that's Celsius. Let me minimize this a bit. I want to see what it does when I play a few videos. Now again, so far, you're not going to have like a amazing desktop experience. Like, I notice it is starting to stutter a bit here as I'm just trying to open up another browser, but it's starting to normalize. Okay, well, that video is starting to stutter, but so far it's starting to kind of be okay a little bit. And checking in with our temps. Yeah, usage is climbing for sure. Check our command line temperature. It's staying steady at 51, so that active cooling is working. Let's open up a third video. We are really putting this GPU through its paces. And we're not even doing 4K yet. We're just doing 720p. So yeah, my videos are starting to stutter a little bit. Temperature's climbing. So lots of things happening. I'm playing four YouTube videos, which I assume you probably don't do, most people anyway. And let's just see if I can do other stuff while it's doing that. So like multitasking things. Now I can definitely feel my mouse lagging. Yeah, it's laggy. CPU is almost maxed out. GPU is having a hard time. And if I were to open just another web browser, it's usable. Using that word usually. Using that word usually. When is the Raspberry Pi 5 coming out? So I can still do things while playing 4 YouTube videos. That's impressive. For the average person, for the kid learning coding or whatever it is, this is pretty great performance. Now I want to try something different here. I want to connect to my NAS. The NAS that's actually right behind me. Can you see him? There he is. And I want to see transfer speeds. I want to download a 4K file and see how it plays here. I want to play two 4K files right here on my 4K monitors. Let's try it out. Let's stop all my YouTube videos here. Now I do want to say this. Right now, we're just having fun. I'm not doing a super in-depth technical review. I just want to show you what it can do, what it kind of feels like to just use it, how you might use it with watching 4 YouTube videos. Yeah, that makes sense. So now let's get connected to my NAS. Temperature has dipped. Things are normalized now. And I'll do that right after I remember how to mount an SMB drive. Okay, I've mounted my share. Now let's connect an Ethernet cable because doing it on Wi-Fi wouldn't be fair. Okay, I have my share mounted. Now what I want to do is go download a file real quick. Go to my current projects. What do you say we do the project we're working on right now? Raspberry Pi 5. And actually, video editor, blur out everything else. I don't want them to know what we're working on. All right, I'm gonna open it with VLC Media Player. Okay, this is a full 4K file. it's going kind of slow. It is playing. There's not a lot of motion right there. Yeah, that's laggy. Whereas when I'm on a normal computer, this does play pretty fine. Full 4K going over the network, kind of murdering it right now. Now, what do you say we transfer that file? It's only 5 gigs. We'll open that in VLC. Taking forever to give me my context menu on this. There we go. Now, this is playing on the local operating system on the SD card. Ooh, that didn't look good. Well, it's it's hurting. It's telling me it's played 25 seconds worth of footage. I haven't seen anything. Okay. Ooh. So 4K footage. Isn't working great. Okay, so I'm like watching my stuff in my academy and it's actually pretty good. So doing stuff like this, normal desktop stuff, I think is gonna be great. Unless I have another tab open and I'm researching stuff. Okay, this keyboard, it lacks usability. I don't like it. But I will say it's playing this 1080p video pretty good. Well, and I say that, it stuttered a bit. So here I'm using LibreOffice, a free version of Office for Linux. And also anything else, I'm pretty sure. This keyboard's killing me. So right now I'm actually running quite a number of things. I'm playing a video on my Academy. I'm installing VS Code. I'm using LibreOffice to take notes. And it's not doing too bad. Okay, well, and it does lag from time to time. It just lags. You're not gonna be the most productive person in the office. And now we're launching VS Code. Like overall, this is pretty usable. I'm happy with it. Now I have a question for you. Do you think the Raspberry Pi 5 can run IT Pro TV? Let's try it out. So I'll launch my browser here on my Raspberry Pi 5 and navigate out to IT Pro TV by ACI Learning, my favorite IT training provider and the sponsor of this video. Ooh, let's check out practical pen testing. Now, as you play with the Raspberry Pi, you'll find that you're actually learning IT skills. Skills that you could build, grow, and turn into an entire career. In fact, that's what I did when I bought my first Raspberry Pi. That's why I bought it. I wanted to learn Linux, and I did. But it's on learning sites like IT Pro TV where I really honed my skills and filled in the gaps that I didn't really learn by just tinkering with the Pi. So going through courses like the Linux Plus, you'll learn a ton in a course like this, and you'll also get a certification and put it on your resume to help you get a job. And then maybe one of your projects is building a router out of your Raspberry Pi, which is really, really fun. And you think to yourself, man, networking is kind of awesome. I kind of want to do that all the time, because you should. Well, for that, they have networking certification courses here on IT Pro TV. They've got the Cisco CCNA, the gold standard in IT certifications, DevNet Associate, security. Or maybe you're just getting started in IT, you're trying to figure out what you want to do with your life. That's where CompTIA might come in. Go for your CompTIA IT Fundamentals, or dive right into the CompTIA A+, which is what I got as my first certification, and it helped me land a job in IT. That's where I got my first start. So if you find yourself tinkering with the Raspberry Pi and you're like, man, I wish I could do this stuff all the time, you can. Start learning IT, check out IT Pro TV, what I use to learn. I got a link below, use the code NetworkChuck, you'll get 30% off forever, and you could do this kind of amazing stuff all the time. Anyways, back to talking about the Raspberry Pi 5. The Pi 4 versus the Pi 5, who's gonna win? Let's do that right now. The first test we'll run is CPU. First, we'll do single threaded, ready, set, go. Time for the Pi 5. Ready, set, go. I'm actually really excited to see this one. Pi 4, 700 events per second. Pi 5, 1000 events per second. So far looking pretty good. Now let's go multi-threaded. We'll up our threads to 4, Pi 4, 28,000, Pi 5, 41,000. I went ahead and ran Geekbench on these Raspberry Pis. Pi 4 and Pi 5. I didn't know you could run Geekbench on Raspberry Pis. That's kind of amazing. Here's the results. Also, little note, the Geekbench ran significantly faster on the Pi 5 versus the Pi 4. Like, it was done in no time. Now let's talk about the results. Here on the Raspberry Pi 4. Here's the score, 258 single core, 695 multi-core. A lot of things to look at and talk about. One thing I kind of want to keep in mind is machine learning. Let's check out multi-core performance. And check out the crypto score too, because the new Raspberry Pi 5 has a cryptographic engine or some kind of enhancements on the CPU. And now for the Pi 5. Look at that! 597 for the single core, 1530 for the multi-core. Kind of killed it, in a good way. Crypto score killed it. 578 versus 40 on the Raspberry Pi 4. Just every metric knocking out of the park. And machine learning doubled, more than doubled. And multi-core is crazier. I'll put the results below, but it's kind of insane. Well, what was that crypto score again? Crypto score 654, 158 on the Pi 4. Not even close. And machine learning, again, 284 versus 189 on the Pi 4. Pi 5 is killer. Now let's benchmark the browser and see how the Pi 4 compares to the Pi 5. And this is an important one because a lot of people, when they're using a Raspberry Pi as their desktop, mainly use the browser. It's the main thing. So let's check it out. Pi 4, let's go. I'm using Speedometer 2.0, start the test. Lots of to-dos, that's honestly kind of stressing me out. But let's just drink some coffee and go with it. Okay, Pi 4, 19.2, is that good? I'm not sure, let's test it on the Pi 5. Ready, set, go. More stressful to-dos, I don't like this. Whoa, 54.6, are you kidding me? That's pretty sick. GPU testing time. We're gonna play the game called Open Arena. Pi 4 is up first, 1280 by 720. Let's see what happens. FPS is not great. We're like under, okay, it's killing, it's dying. Who's that? Okay, it's unplayable. If I stay still, it's 15 frames per second. Okay, I just wanna kill someone, one person. That person was me. Time for the Pi 5. 1280 by 720p, let's get started. This is so much better. Oh my gosh, look at the FPS. This is insane. The real test is if I can kill somebody. Now I know people mod this to get better frame rates. This is just out of box. I haven't changed anything. I got it! Okay, that's the real test. I got someone. Now let's dial it down just a bit more to make it more fair. On the Pi 4, I'll do 640 by 180. This is so tiny. How do I make this bigger? Let's see what FPS we get here. I'm keeping all the same settings, not doing anything fancy at all. FPS is a lot better with nothing. Okay, so FPS is pretty good. All right, same story on the Pi 5. Let's drop it down to, what was it? 640 by 480. Super tiny. Can barely see it. I better get like 3000 FPS on this. Yeah, it's ridiculous. Like we're hitting 100 FPS. Okay, we tested the Pis and clearly the Pi 5 is just, it's ridiculous. It's the winner. It only took 4 years. But at least it came out in 2023 and not in 2024. Right, Mr. Upton? Yes.